the art I incorporate with graffiti art is stemmed from thousands of years back. And kind of what I'm doing nowadays is just the fact that I'm painting in the same way, but the graffiti scene, being able to incorporate my native images with graffiti art, being able to be the messenger of being able to do that for people, you know, putting feathers on my spray cans and, you know, putting straight native and asking people where they're at in their Native American life. Anymore, it's just been an assimilation into what's been there for them, being from the reservation and everything. And what I want to do is break free from that, being able to put my ideas, my concepts for that, which I got from, you know, hundreds of years back, being able to do that and still bring it to the people. The other night, the police stopped me painting on this very wall just for the fact, I could say it's racism, but at the same time, I know better. If they wanted to do what they wanted to do because it's their job, that's their job. I can't do a damn thing about it. But what they did is they stopped me. They interrogated me to a sense where they figured that I was some random making nonsense. Same way, I do this for the people, whether it's my people or anybody's people, because we're all related. They made me pack up my paint, and they sat there, interrogated me, brought out my ID, brought out everything that I did. I had pictures in my backpack of all the things I did, of everything that I've done in my lifetime. And of course, they didn't realize it here in Rapid City, or, well, what I mean by realize is they didn't notice it, because I've never done any graffiti all over Rapid City. I've done it on my reservation, but in the same way, they try to catch me for something. They might have thought I was somebody else, but I wasn't. Related. And that's just the way people always talk in my res. And so being from there, you do things for the Oyate and for the and from the Oyate, stemming from my, you know, just who I am, just everything that I do. They used to write on their buffalo robes and everything, from making their own paint and finding their own ways to make it and everything. I'm somebody who used to come from there, so I know that what it's like to make the paint and paint and let people know what it is they need to know about today. Because in a way, this is my winter camp. In a way, this is what I do to make myself feel like I'm doing something for the people, being able to do that and still bring it to the people, other than my people. That's what you give in life is what's immortalized when you go. Because what you do for yourself, it dies with you. But what you do for the people, it's immortalized and people tend to remember it. And that's what I know.